एक में पहले आगे ने इंडिया का खाने का मार्केट एंटर किया और 8 साल के बाद उसने हिप्पो लॉन्च किया। ये टोस्ट
बांटते चलो प्यार, बांटते चलो हे प्यार, बांटते चलो प्यार, बांटते चलो प्यार, बांटते चलो।
If I remember it correctly, when I was like 8 or something, there used to be a snack with a bright colored packaging that was a bit different from the other products like Lay's and Kurkure. And not only that, it provided baked potato chips instead of fried. Until now, you might have guessed which product I'm talking about. For those of you who still couldn't get your heads around, or you might not genuinely know about or have seen or heard of it, I am talking about the discontinued product of Hippo Snacks or Munchies. I still remember the time when I was obsessed with it. My school canteen was filled with the packets of Hippo chips. My granddad, who always used to poke me about my health whenever he saw me eating snacks, I finally had something to counter him by. I used to say, "Look, Babaji, I can finally eat these as much as I want, as it is healthy unlike the others." To which he was never convinced. But around 2013 to 2014, these Hippo chips completely stopped roaming around the market, which was super frustrating for me and for my friends who were a fan of these snacks as well. It's been 6 to 7 years from now and I still remember it so well, and I'm sure some of you guys might even remember it as well, which made me realize, why did it even stop all of a sudden? And what were the impacts and how did it even reach to the top in the first place? Welcome to the first Rise and Fall series, where in this video, I'm gonna discuss the rise and fall of the brand Hippo. Hippo was launched in 2009 with 5 flavors: pizza, Chinese Manchurian, hot and sweet tomato, Thai chili and yogurt mint chutney. Well, my personal favorite ones were obviously pizza and Chinese Manchurian. Let me know your favorite ones in the comments below. So, the market men were aware of the growing trend of the healthy foods in the food segment of India among the public. So, they wanted to introduce a quote-unquote healthy snack in the market in order to make it in the mainstream category. Although the trend was limited to certain sections at the time, they knew it would grow at a very increasing rate. And they were right. After the launch of Hippo, the healthy snacks section faced a great boom in the market, along with other brands who tried to do as same as Hippo. PepsiCo launched Aliva brand, which was discontinued later on. Parle introduced Maneco Smart Chips. Lay's and Bingo tried to lay their hands at the low-calorie version of the baked not fried proposition. But what happened to Hippo in particular? Parle Agro entered the food segment in 2001 and it entered the Indian snack industry in 2009 after launching Hippo. Hippo was different. It was neither potato chips nor biscuits. Rather, it claimed to be this new wheat snack and was supposed to be a hunger killer. It claimed to be free from MSG, monosodium glutamate, and GMO, genetically modified organism, to prove that it is healthy. It wanted to be a guilt-free snack for hunger moments, as well as a snack to fill the stomach. It also had a striking way of packaging, as it used bright and unconventional colors mainly to stand out in the clutter shops. Its advertisement campaigns also had an interwoven social message, which was strikingly unique and different from its competitors, as they usually focus solely on taste. The Hippo brand chooses to communicate to its customers by telling a story. And like any other story, it also had a premise, which was, hunger is the root cause of all evil, and the brand motto was, fight hunger, fight evil. Its mascot, a hippo, did go along with the personality. It was so good that its stock ran out constantly. The brand performed so well in its category, it left the shelves of across 2 lakh stores empty. But no brand does well without facing some challenges. Hippo's case was no different. After Hippo's launch, the Indian snack industry received an extremely impressive response from all over India. Within few months, the demand grew more and more, and it was difficult to meet it. The retail shops went empty so fast, which led to a demand-supply problem for the company. But to overcome the problem, the brand came up with an innovative solution. Hippo joined social media in 2010 and asked the followers to tweet for the unavailability of snacks in the neighborhood stores. Tweets came from numerous cities in India, and this campaign brought a huge number of followers from India. Hippo collected the data from Twitter, analyzed and sent the information to the local distributors of certain shops, who eventually restocked their retail shelves within no time. This was a very impressive way to fix the demand-supply problem instead of using the conventional methods. It helped the customers by direct communication. Through Twitter, Hippo was able to bring equilibrium among demand and supply. Its sales rose by 76% in the initial phase. The people had an amazing experience to learn how a simple tweet can restock the retail stores and fulfill their demands. One other challenge that Hippo had to face was fierce competition. It wanted to stand out in an already crowded snack market and create a strong brand preference in the minds of the customers. It wanted to do something innovative, which could make it stand out over its competitors. So, Hippo came up with another campaign, Indian Food League. It was capitalized by Creativeland Asia. IFL was catchy, funny, and was designed to engage cricket fans during the IPL. Now, I'm not really gonna talk about the IFL because, first of all, I cannot make this video too long, and second, it did not have that much of an impact as it intended to. Not many audiences were engaged in it, plus it was not that interesting. So, these were the problems that Hippo brand had to face and the strategies that it took to overcome the problem. But what exactly happened after that? Why did the brand stop? Even though the Hippo brand tried to overcome the problem of fierce competition by launching a digital campaign, the results were not that great, and it genuinely did not matter in the end because its competitors in the healthy snack industry did not seem to be that good, so they did not have to put in much efforts as well. But Hippo was liked for its taste, and after 2011, its stock kept on fluctuating until the day it completely stopped. In 2014, Hippo posted its last tweet on 12th May 2014. It's been 6 years since it died, and a lot many people have moved on. Most of them did not even realize that it had stopped circulating in the retail stores. It was tragic news to receive in the end, but like every other product, Hippo also had an expiry date. There are not much people talking about it. There are case studies discussing the brand. I'll put the link in the description if you'd like to get into it. But most of them are dated even before the brand was even discontinued. However, the marketeers or Parley Agro never revealed why they did it. But I might have a theory. See, the reason why Hippo as a brand had worked so well in the first place was because of the trend of healthy snacks. Hippo brought healthy snacks in the mainstream category, but that does not mean that it is going to be permanent. Many articles at that time flooded around informing the customers that the so-called healthy snacks are not actually healthy. Eventually, the people grew out of it, and that's when Hippo's brand started to die out slowly. But that's just my opinion. There might be others telling their own stories or perspectives which might actually be correct. I mean, in the end, these are just theories. Hippo as a brand could have done wonders had it survived in the long run, given its history of innovative ideas and techniques. It had a catchy name, good product qualities, excellent packaging, good pricing, and distribution reach. But now, with the rise of these new alternative snacks like Snackable and 2Yum, I say even if Hippo decides to do a comeback, I don't think it will have that much of an impact in the market. So, you've reached the outro section of the video and I'm glad that you did. I'm still learning and experimenting on various things, but do let me know what you think of the video and also tell me which other brands I should possibly make a video next. The reason why I took Hippo as my first topic of discussion was that since the beginning, it had been my favorite snack and I would still prefer it over any other, if only had it been there. Although I grew out of it, I still miss it very much and it was nice having it as my favorite snack since I was a kid. But some things you gotta let go. Though there is a petition going on in the change.org, do sign it if you also miss Hippo Toasties like I do. I will put it as my first link in the description below. I hope you enjoyed the video. Do like and subscribe and you might send this video to the people who loved Hippo since they were a kid also. It was a good time and I'm glad that it existed. Okay, I'm gonna go now. Bye bye.